lanthanide contraction. That is the last topic in your SLS class. So what is this lanthanide contraction? The gradual decrease in atomic and ionic size of lanthanide elements as the atomic number increases, which is called as lanthanide contraction. What is the reason behind it? Reason for this one is, first one, pore screening effect. Of f orbitals pore screening effect of f orbitals due to their dispersed shape next second reason is that is every newly added electron entered into anti-penultimate shell that is n minus 2 shell end, which is nearer to the nucleus and also increase in nuclear charge as Z value increases. These are the reasons for this lanthanide contraction. These are the two reasons. Now, what is lanthanide contraction? As Z value increases, atomic size and ionic size gradually decreases. In lanthanide element, that is called as lanthanide contraction. Now, what are the consequences of this one? So, consequences anyway. Consequences of lanthanide contraction. What are the consequences of lanthanide contraction? Because of this lanthanide contraction, the one and most important one is basic nature of lanthanide hydroxide gradually decreases. As Z value increases. Because size decreases, basic nature decreases. Basic nature decreases. And second and most important one is, we know chemical twins. What are those chemical twins? Zirconium and hafnium. These have similar chemical properties. As their sizes are equal. Due to this lanthanide contraction. So these are the most important consequences points towards this lanthanide contraction. So this is the statement. These are the reasons behind this. So because of this concept, so consequences are here. So these are only, these are also due to next slide. Next. In atomic radius, there is three types of radii are there. One is metallic radius, which is also called as atomic radius, which is also called as crystal radius. Crystal's radius is also same. The word that was, I missed there. Atomic radius, metallic radius, or crystal radius. All these three are same. And the second one is covalent radius, and the third one is van der Waals radius. All those are as usual. Okay, so these are the points. Now I am going to discuss some bits based on this atomic size. So atomic size, some bits. Now, in according to our atomic size, bond length of AB molecule is equal to radius of A plus radius of B. So any diatomic molecule, their bond length should be equal to the sum of the radii of those two bonded atoms. Sum of the radii of the two bonded atoms. Based on this point, I am going on a problem. So that is, say that XY bond distance, XY bond distance is 1.2 angstroms. The radius of Y is 0.8 angstroms. Radius of X is equal to how much? Radius of X is equal to how much? Here is the XY molecule, just like the AB molecule. Their bond length is equal to radius of the first one plus radius of second one. Therefore, 1.2 is equal to 0.8 plus radius of X. Therefore, radius of X is equal to how much? 0.4 is the answer, and which is in angstroms. 0.4 is the answer. Next, simple one. Yes. Next, another model. The radius of M is 1.2 angstroms. Then radius of M plus ion is equal to how much? Radius of M plus ion is equal to how much? The given options are 1.2 angstroms, 2.2 angstroms, 3 1.9 angstroms, 4 0.98 angstroms. So what is the reason behind it? So atom, it is M and E, it is M plus N. So when compared to neutral atom, cation radius is should be less than. Therefore, radius of M is greater than that of its cation. So that means its value should be less than this one. Should be less than this one. So here is equal. That is not possible. Here more than that one, not accepted. Here it is also more than that one, not accepted. The only value which is less than that of is 0.98. That is why this is all. There is no need of calculation. It is just based on your knowledge. That is more, less, equal. So based on that, the problems are solved. So there are certain values. How to calculate that? No need to calculation. No need of calculation, my dear boys. Okay? So just, is this more than that one or less than that one or equal to that one? Just identify that one. Okay? So these are the different methods to calculate. Now see here. Radius of carbon is equal to 0.77 angstroms. Radius of chlorine is equal to 0.99 angstroms. Now, CCl bond length is equal to how much? CCl bond length. So, sum of the radii of the two bonded atoms is equal to bond length. That is equal to 0.77 plus 0.999. 0.77 plus 0.99. So, how much is the value? 1.76 is the answer, which is also in angstroms. Okay, so just simple calculations So please keep your mind on it. Now, today's topic, that is ionization energy or ionization enthalpy. Ionization energy or ionization enthalpy. What is the meaning of ionization? Ionization means making of an atom into its positively charged ion. Conversion of that neutral atom into positively charged ion is called as ionization. For that purpose, something energy should be required. That required energy is called as ionization energy. See here. It is the neutral atom. So here is the nucleus of that neutral atom. All the total positive charge is located at that point. So these are the different orbits, which is the last orbit. See here, this is the nth orbit ending. It is the nth orbit. There is an electron in this nth orbit. There are number of inner orbits are there. These are the core orbits. These are the core orbits. But electron removing or electron adding, all these are only from outermost orbit. Addition of electron only to the outermost orbit. Removal of electron only from the outermost orbit. Core electrons not involved in any losing or gaining condition. Okay. So now I want to remove this electron. I want to remove this electron which is in the outermost orbit. That should be in the last orbit. Now, here, there is an attractive force between that nucleus and the valence electron. That nucleus and valence electron, there is an attractive force. That means this electron is influenced by this nuclear attraction. That means there is an attraction. Now, I want to remove this electron from here to outside. From here to outside, that means, so come that electron, please come, and it is not possible to come out that electron itself. That is why it requires something energy to remove that electron. So now I applied some energy to remove this electron. So I want to apply some force, some energy to bring that electron. Okay, so that is why that applied energy to remove this electron, that means that energy should be greater than that of this energy. That means there is an attractive force, something force is applied here, some energy, attractive force is there. So against to this attractive force, something energy should be applied. That energy should be greater than that of this attractive force. That energy, because of that one, the electron is coming out from the neutral atom. Now this one is converted into a unipositively charged ion. That means if A is there, it loses its electron and converts into positively charged atom. That means energy is lost by that atom. So electron losing or gaining is only if the atom is in gaseous stage. If the atom is in gaseous state, only the losing of electron or addition of electron is possible. Only the atom should be in gaseous state. Why, sir? Why it should be always in gaseous state? Because gaseous atom has highest energy. So gaseous atom has highest energy. So there is a need of less energy is sufficient to remove that valence electron. Or addition of electron is also possible only in the gaseous state. That is why. So losing of electrons or gaining of electrons of an atom is always in its gaseous stage. So that's why. So what is this energy? This energy is called as ionization energy of that atom. Ionization energy of that atom. So what is ionization energy? It is the energy required or applied to remove the valence electron from the outermost gaseous atom. Outermost shell of the gaseous atom. The minimum energy required to remove an electron from the outermost orbit of a gaseous neutral atom is called as ionization energy. Ionization energy. Let it be sodium atom, gaseous sodium atom. Its atomic number Z is equal to 11. That means it has 11 protons and 11 electrons. That means inside contains 11 protons, outside contains 11 electrons. This should be the 11th electron. That should be the 11th electron. That 11th electron is going to remove it. So now that sodium converts into, that sodium is converted into Na plus ion, which is also in gaseous state. So sodium neutral atom converted into sodium ion. Here it contains the same number of protons, but one electron should be less. 10 electrons. That means now this is the last one. So see here, it is a sodium gaseous atom. So converted into Na plus gaseous ion and the loss of electron. Now it is a unit, that is a single positive charge. Single positive charge. That is why it is called as unipositively charged ion. Positively charged ion. Here, number of protons should be greater than that of number of electrons. Number of protons should be greater than that of number of electrons. That means now 11 protons attract only 10 electrons. Only 10 electrons. Now I want to remove one more electron. So this is the first electron removing. Now that energy is called as first ionization energy. Simply called as I1. First ionization energy, which is called as I1 energy. Now I want to remove one more electron from this one. So that means 11 protons attracts 10 electrons. So there is a strong attractive force of this nucleus over the remaining electrons. So because of that, something more energy. This is the 10th electron. Let it be the 10th electron. This is the 11th electron already lost. This should be the 10th electron. Now I have to remove. I want to remove this electron. That means it requires more energy than previous energy. More energy than previous, because it is strongly attracted by these 11 electrons, 11 protons. So something nuclear force of attraction is more on this electron than that of previous case. Therefore, this energy is called as IE2, second ionization energy, which is called as I2. No doubt here, I2, second ionization enthalpy value, is always greater than first ionization energy. Second ionization energy is always greater than that of first ionization energy. No doubt it is perfected. So ionization energy is also called as ionization enthalpy. That means energy changes. Energy changes is expressed in terms of enthalpy. Here we applied energy, or that released energy. Here we applied energy, because removal of that electron needs some energy. I applied some energy on that electron for the removal of that electron. That is why I applied that energy. That energy is, I supply to the atom. Because of that attractive forces. Okay? I supply to, that means it is the energy, that the process gains energy. The process gains energy, required energy. My energy is required to remove that electron. That requires energy. Now it is an endothermic process. Endothermic means energy absorbed process. Energy absorbed. This absorbs some energy, removes that electron, releases that electron. So energy absorbed process is called as endothermic. Energy released process is called as exothermic. Ionization enthalpy is an endothermic process. Ionization energy is endothermic process, because it is the absorbed energy. It absorbs something energy for the removal of that electron. Okay, see here once again. So second ionization enthalpy is greater than that of first ionization enthalpy. What is first ionization enthalpy? There is the energy required to remove the one first electron, to remove the last electron present in the neutral atom. But in second case, already one electron is lost, that entire positive charge is strongly held, strongly attracts that remaining electrons. That means there is a strong attractive force than that of previous is now available. To remove that strong attractive forces, something more energy is required to remove the second electron. That's why second ionization enthalpy should be greater than that of first ionization enthalpy. It is due to nuclear attraction over the remaining electrons in second case is very, very high. That means high nuclear charge in charge. That is simply called as high nuclear charge. Because of high nuclear charge over the remaining electrons, so it requires something more than that of previous energy. That is the second ionization enthalpy should be greater than first energy. So if we want to remove one more electron, something more energy is required. That means I3 greater than I2 greater than I1. So I4 greater than I3 greater than I2 greater than I1. So these are the different cases. So how many electrons I want to remove, sir? So we will remove how many electrons? As much as the number of electrons are there. For example, 10 electrons are there. 10 electrons are going to remove. That means 10 ionization enthalpies are there. If 20 electrons are there, 20 electrons are there, 20 electrons are removed. Already. That means 20 ionization enthalpy values. 20 ionization enthalpy values. Okay. So all these are the, that means for an atom, how many ionization enthalpies are possible? For an atom, how many ionization enthalpies are possible? That means atomic number of enthalpies are possible. Atomic number. That means atomic number of electrons are there. All those electrons are, I'm trying to remove those electrons. That means that much ionization energies are there. That means for any atom, the maximum number of ionization enthalpies are equal to its atomic number. The maximum number of ionization enthalpies are equal to its atomic number. Okay? So, see here. See here, there is a neutral atom which is in ground state. I apply something energy, that A loses its electron and converts into unipositively charged atom. This energy is called as first ionization energy. Next, I want to remove one more electron, something energy is once again applied. So one more electron is lost, that is why it converts into a dipositive ion, which is also in gaseous state by the loss of one more electron. That means second electron is removed and it is the first electron is removed and first electron is removed. Here it is, the second electron is removed and so that is a dipositive ion is formed. Here this energy is called as second ionization enthalpy. If we want to remove one more electron, that is something energy is applied. So one more electron is lost, it is a tripositive ion which is also in gaseous state. Third electron is removed. This energy is called as third ionization energy, which is I3. In every case, I1 should be less than, I2 should be less than, I3 should be less than, something else. So every time there is a nuclear reaction over the remaining electrons is very, very high. Because of that, more energy is required to remove one more electron. To remove one more electron, that is the ionization enthalpy as the number of electrons removed is automatically increases. Okay, so these are all ionization enthalpies or ionization energy. That is the minimum energy required to remove the electron from the outermost orbit of a gaseous neutral atom. It is first ionization enthalpy. What is second ionization enthalpy? It is the energy required, it is not minimum. It is the energy required to remove one more electron from unipositively charged ion. One more electron from unipositively charged ion is called as the second ionization enthalpy. What is third ionization enthalpy? It is the energy required to remove third electron, one more electron from a dipositive ion, gaseous ion, is called as a third ionization, just like this, different number of ionization enthalpies. So for an atom, the number, maximum number of ionization enthalpies is equal to its Z value. Maximum number of ionization enthalpies is equal to its Z value. That means that all the available number of electrons are going to remove with the help of huge amount of energy cell. So it is possible. Theoretically, it is possible. Practically, it requires something more energy cell. More energy. Every time, all these cases, positively charged ions are appeared. So neutral atoms are converted into positively charged ions. Okay? So that is Z. Z is nothing but atomic number. Atomic number of ionization enthalpies are possible. Okay, So now, what are the factors that influencing, my dear boy, this is nothing but ionization energy or ionization enthalpy, nothing but energy end. What are the units of this ionization energy? Units. What are the units of this ionization energy? So ionization energy is nothing but energy end. Energy. So all energy units are applicable. All energy units are applicable. Energy units means electron volts, kilojoules, joules, calories, ergs, all these are energy units. Everything is applicable. Everything. Joule is the MKS unit, erg is the CGS unit. So all other cases, electron volts per atom, so everything is applicable. So all energy units are applicable to ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy. So now what are the factors that are influencing on ionization enthalpy? So these are important, listen carefully. Factors influencing on ionization enthalpy. Factors influencing on ionization enthalpy. So what are those factors? Here, in your 10th class, three factors are there, but here five factors are applied. So one is atomic size or atomic radius. Atomic size or atomic radius is the first factor. Second factor, nuclear charge. Nuclear charge. Third one, penetrating power. Fourth one, screening effect, already I told to you. And last one, electronic configuration. These are the five factors influencing on ionization enthalpy. Because of these, sometimes more energy may be required than we expected, or less energy required than we expected. So what are the factors which influence ionization energy? Atomic size or atomic radius, nuclear charge, penetrating power, screening effect, and lastly, electronic configuration. Now we are going one by one here. See here. Atomic size or atomic radius. What is atomic size or atomic radius? It is the distance between the center of the nucleus to the outermost orbit of an atom or outermost electron of an atom. That is atomic radius. Now I am going to consider two atoms. Let it be, this is the first atom. Here is the nucleus. Let it be A. Here is an electron. Now I want to remove this electron. This is the radius of A. This is the radius of A. Okay. Now, I'm going to say one more atom. So, see here. This is A. There is one more atom like this. This is its nucleus. This is its electron. This is the radius of B. Let it be B atom. No doubt, radius of B should be greater than radius of A. From this explanation, it is small size, it is a big size. Radius of B greater than that of radius of A. Now, I want to remove this electron by applying something energy. Let it be EEN. For this, it is EBN. Now, which is more, which is less? Here, there is a large gap, the large distance between this nucleus and this electron. That means nuclear attraction over this electron is less. Nuclear attraction over this electron is less. But in this case, this is at shortest distance. That means here nuclear attraction is more energy. Nuclear attraction is more. That means the energy required to remove this electron is more than that of to remove this electron. Okay, because this is small in size, this is more in size. Here more energy, more attraction between nucleus and outermost electron. Here less attraction between nucleus and outermost electron. That is why it has more energy. It requires more energy to remove this electron because strong attraction is there. Here less attraction is there. Less energy is sufficient. Therefore, EA should be greater than EB energy. That means small is the size of the atom. Small is the size of the atom. Ionization energy is high energy. So small is, that means ionization energy is inversely proportional to atomic radius or atomic size. More is the size, less is the attraction between nucleus and outermost electron. That is easy to remove that electron. That means less ionization energy is sufficient if atom size is more. Therefore, ionization energy is inversely proportional to size. Is inversely proportional to size energy. Atomic size or ionic size energy. Okay, this is first case energy. So those atoms having less size, having more ionization energy. More ionization. Ionization energy is inversely proportional to size or radius of the atom. Next, the second one. Nuclear charge. Let us take two identical atoms. Their sizes are equal. Let it be A atom. This one also same size. Let it be B atom. These two atoms, let it be size same ending. Size same. My dear boys, please consider these two atoms. I think, okay, both are almost in same size. So we consider these two are same size. Here, 20 protons inside the nucleus. Here, 10 protons inside the nucleus. So see here, so are 11 protons inside the nucleus. 11 protons inside the nucleus. Here is the electron, here also electron. The distance between these two and these two are equivalent because same size. But here 20 electrons attract this electron. Here only 11 protons attract this one. Here 20 protons attract this electron. Here 11 protons attract this one. That means here, nuclear attraction over electron is more energy because more is the positive charge. Here, nuclear attraction is less energy. That means here is the less attraction. So now I want to remove an electron. Here is the energy used, let it be EB. Here is the energy used, which is E energy. So where more energy is required to remove that electron? More is the attraction, more is the energy required. More is the attraction, more is the energy required. Here more attraction is there. That means here EA greater than that of EB. EA greater than that of EB. That means more is the attraction. That means more is the positive charge, more is the nuclear charge. More nuclear charge, more attraction. More attraction, more energy charge. Less attraction, less ionization energy. That means ionization energy is in directly proportional to nuclear charges. More nuclear charge, more ionization energy. Less nuclear charge, less ionization energy. That means what is the relation between nuclear charge and ionization energy? Both are directly proportional to each other. Both are directly proportional. That means as atomic number increases, so nuclear charge may be increased. So something may be applicable. All together, finally, we are going to conclude it. So see here, after completion of these factors, I'm giving some examples, so automatically that will be clarified. Next, an important one, which is penetrating power. What is this penetrating power? Penetrating power, see here. This is the atom. This is the nucleus of the atom. These are the number of orbits. These are the number of orbits. Here is the valence yardage. Let it be n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, 3, 4. These are the arbit numbers. This is the nth arbit, that is ultimate arbit. In this fourth arbit, four sub-energy levels are there. Fourth arbit contains four sub-energy levels, that is S orbital, P orbital, D orbital, and F orbital. And S, P, D, and F. There exist four different orbitals. Okay. So all these four orbitals having electrons. So everywhere electron is there. Here one electron, here electron, here electron, here electron are there. Whatever it may be the electron, that should be from the outermost orbit. If you want to remove the electron from the outermost orbit, any one of these to be removed. Any one of these to be removed. So that should be the removal of electron from the outermost orbit. But one electron from S orbital, another electron from P orbital, another one D, and a last one F orbital. So these orbitals have different shapes. These orbitals have different shapes. S orbital has, this S orbital has spherical shape. The shape of S orbital is spherical. Shape of P orbital is dumbbell ended. Shape of P orbital is a dumbbell shape ending. It is a double dumbbell ending. Double dumbbell ending. And last one is, already yesterday I told you, dispersed shape ending. Dispersed shape ending. That is not particular shape ending. Okay, three, four, something. So these are the different shapes of orbitals. Because of these different shapes, those orbitals attracted by that nucleus, someone are more strongly or someone are weak strongly. So here, because of spherical shape, this S orbital and this S electron is strongly attracted with the nucleus. Is strongly attracted with the nucleus. But dumbbell shape, because of dumbbell shape, something less attraction, almost less attraction. Almost less attraction. So my dear boys, okay. See here, because of the different shapes, those orbital are strongly held, differently attracted by the nucleus. S orbital is strongly attracted, that means S electron is strongly attracted, that means because of that reason, once again I am trying here, this is the nth orbit, S electron is strongly attracted, than P electron, than D electron, than F electron. That means this S electron something nearer to the nucleus, F electron far away from each other. That means the tendency of an orbital to attract towards nucleus is called as penetration. So the penetrating power is high for S orbital. Penetrating power is high for S orbital. That's why this S electron very near to the nucleus, P electron, then D electron, then S electron. Now, which electron is easy to remove? Which electron is possible to easy to remove? It is strongly attracted. It is weakly attracted. That means removal of this electron is very easy at the end of the top. Yes, that means here penetrating power is less. Energy is also less than. Penetrating power is less. Energy is also less. That means the tendency of an electron to attract towards nucleus, moving towards nucleus is called as penetration. That penetrating power order is S greater than P greater than D greater than F1. The order of penetrating power is S greater than P greater than D greater than F. So more is the penetrating power, difficult to remove that electron, more is the ionization energy. So penetrating power is directly proportional to ionization energy. Penetrating power is directly proportional to ionization energy. Therefore, ionization energy order, IP, ionization energy or ionization potential, both are same. IP order is S greater than P greater than D greater than F. S greater than P greater than D greater than F. The tendency of an electron present in the orbital moving towards nucleus is the penetration. That is very high for S orbital and least for P orbital. The order is S greater than P greater than D greater than F. So more is the penetration. So more is the attraction with the nucleus. Difficult to remove that electron. More is the ionization energy. That means penetration power is high. Ionization energy is also high. So penetrating power and ionization energy both are directly proportional to each other. Both are directly proportional to each other. That penetrating power depending on the shape of those orbitals. Depending on the shape of those orbitals. This is ionization, that is particularly penetrating power condition. So is there any doubts? So more is the penetration power, more is the energy required to remove that electron. Next. That is the third one. Now fourth one. What is that screening effect? Already I told to you yesterday. Screening effect. What is screening effect? Decreasing of nuclear attraction over the outermost electron because of core electron. Because of core electron. So what is that? See here. This is the atom. These are the number of orbitals. Here. One more atom. These are the number of orbitals. These are the number of orbitals. Now, I want to remove this electron. Here, let it be 10 core electrons are there. Now, here I want to remove one more electron. Here, 5 core electrons are there. Let it be. More is the core electrons, less is the attraction between this nucleus and outermost electron. That means these core electrons decreases the attraction of that nucleus over this outermost electron. That property is called as screening effect. What is screening effect? The tendency of core electrons. So this acts as screen between this nucleus and outermost electron. The tendency of core electrons to decrease the attraction of nucleus over the outermost electrons is called as screening effect. These act as a screen, or these act as a shield. Addukuntundani, just as a shield. So these act as a shield. That is, this screening effect is also called as shielding effect. Screening effect or shielding effect, both are same. So that means a core electrons decrease the attraction of that nucleus over the outermost electron. That effect is, that means those electrons act as a shield. As a shield, that effect is called as a shielding effect or that is a screening effect. So more electrons is there, less is the attraction, easy to remove. And easy to remove. That means ionization energy is less. Ionization energy is less. Therefore, let it be A. This one is B. Here, less is the electron. More is the attraction between them. And so more energy is required to remove that electron. Here ionization energy is more. And ionization energy is more. That means shielding effect is more, ionization energy is less. Shielding effect is less, ionization energy is more. That means the shielding effect is inversely proportional to ionization energy. So shielding effect is due to core electrons. Shielding effect is due to core electrons. Okay, so now it is shielding effect. This shielding effect is inversely proportional to ionization energy. Shielding effect is inversely proportional to ionization energy. So this is screening or shielding effect. Now, and last one, that is electronic configuration. What is this electronic configuration? So electron, during electronic configuration, half filled, we know half filled are completely filled. Orbitals are more stable than others. Half-filled and completely filled orbitals are more stable than others. So this is very, very important. It is symmetric rule set. So if orbitals are half-filled or full-filled, those are very, very stable. Okay? Therefore, elements having this condition, half-filled or completely filled, are more stable. Those elements having that half-filled or completely filled orbitals are also more stable. Therefore, energy required to remove electron from these elements is difficult, is high end. Here is removal of electron from these elements is difficult. Therefore, more energy is required. That means electronic conversion is also influences the removal of electron, energy required to remove the electron. So those orbitals having half-filled or full-filled orbitals are very, very stable. Those elements are most stable. It is difficult to remove electrons from the outermost orbits because those are very, very stable. If they lose that electron, their stability will be decreased. No atom is ready to remove, to decrease. No atom is ready to decrease its stability. Any that is, these are not ready to give that electron. That is why more energy is needed to remove that electron. That is why ionization energy is high. So in this case, ionization energy is high. So this is very, very, very important. So let us take an example. Here. Nitrogen and oxygen. Nitrogen's atomic number Z is equal to 7. Oxygen's Z is equal to 8. Write down the electronic configuration. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. It is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So write down this p3 configuration, p4 configuration, box method. I'm going to write the box method. See here. Here, P3, 1, 2, 3, all those orbitals are half-filled in it. But here, P4, 1, 2, 3, 4 in it. Not half-filled or not full-filled in it. That means nitrogen is more stable in it. It is less stable in it. Therefore, from where electron easy to remove? Less stable atom or from the more stable atom? Oxygen. Yes, that's right. So, ionization energy of oxygen is less than that of ionization energy of nitrogen. Ionization energy of oxygen is less than that of ionization of energy of nitrogen. It is only due to electronic configuration. Okay, next one more. Now one electron is removed. So automatically this nitrogen converts into N plus IR, oxygen converts into O plus IR. First ionization completed. Now this electron is removed and this electron also removed. Now among N plus and O plus, which is more stable? O plus. That's right. Now from where electron easy to remove? N plus or O plus? From N plus. That means second IPL. So second IP of nitrogen is less than second IP of oxygen. First IP of nitrogen is more than that of oxygen, but second IP of oxygen is more than that of nitrogen. Okay, so these are different cases which explains this ionization energy and which influences the ionization energy. These are all different facts that explain ionization energy. Finally, atomic size of ionic rays is inversely proportional to ionization energy. Nuclear charge is directly proportional to ionization energy. Penetrating power is directly proportional to ionization energy. Screening effect is inversely proportional to ionization energy. Electronic configuration, fulfilled or half-filled condition, more energy is required. Fulfilled and half-filled conditions, more energy is required. These are all ionization energy parts. Now, from this ionization energy, okay. Now I'm going to explain that one, sodium and magnesium. See here. So now my topic is that one. Now, general trend energy. Ionization energy, general trend. In period, from left to right, phi is decreased. Already I completed yesterday. In groups, from top to bottom, size increase completed yesterday. Okay. Now, as size increases, ionization energy decreases. As size decreases, ionization energy increases. Ionization energy increases. That means ionization energy from left to right in a period gradually increases because size decreases. From top to bottom, as size increases, ionization energy decreases. Now, among entire periodic table, which one has highest ionization energy? Entire periodic table, altogether the fact. That is the factor. So the highest ionization enthalpy is applicable for, yes, correct, that is helium energy. That is helium is the highest ionization energy element. Helium is the highest ionization because it is the last small in size, stable electronic configuration 1s2, which is completely stable. Okay, so it is highly difficult to remove the electron. Small size, more ionization energy. Stable configuration, more. All together, all conditions are applied. That is why it has highest ionization energy. Least ionization energy for which one? That is the cesium. 1a group element. 1a have less ionization energy than zero group have more ionization energy than zero group have more ionization energies. 1a group have less ionization energies. So in 1a group, from top to bottom, ionization energy decreases. Cesium having least ionization energy. So francium is a radioactive element. Generally, we don't consider that one because that existence is very, very negligible. So cesium is the least ionization energy element. Helium is the highest ionization element. Okay. Now, one by one, in second period, third period, what are the order of ionization energies? Now I'm going to explain here. See here. Second period elements. Let us take second period elements. One of those second period elements, hydrogen, helium are the first elements, first period elements. So after that, after hydrogen, helium, second period element, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Once again, I am writing here. So second period element, what are those elements? Lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Neon. General trend, what I told to you, from left to right, atomic size decreases, ionization energy increases. That means generally ionization energy left to right increases. Left to right. But in particular, just I'm going to explain here. Here it is a three atomic number, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the atomic numbers. These are the atomic numbers. Now I'm going to write the electronic configuration of these elements. So what are those electronic configuration? Lithium. Outermost I'm going to write 1s2 is the inner shell. So 2s1, 1s2, 2s1 is the outer shell. It is 2s2, 2p1. It is 2s2, 2p2. It is 2s2, 2p3. It is 2s2, 2p4. It is 2s2, 2p5. It is 2s2, 2p6. 2s2, 2p6. These are the outermost electronic configuration of those elements. Here, this contains only one electron, this contains two electrons. S orbital, S has one box, it is fulfilled. Fulfilled. That means electron removal from this one is difficult than that of this one. Therefore, ionization energy of lithium is less than that of beryllium. Next. It is 2s2, 2p1. 2s2, 2p1 means it is not half-filled, not fulfilled. If we remove this electron, it gets 2s2. That is stable configuration. That means its ionization energy is less than that of beryllium. So it is greater than boron. My dear boys, so lithium ionization energy less than beryllium, but beryllium ionization energy greater than boron because it is the most stable and fulfilled configuration. Boron. Next, carbon. So small size, that is less than carbon, less than nitrogen, but it is a half filled case. Nitrogen greater than oxygen. Already I explained to you. Nitrogen greater than oxygen. Okay. Next. Oxygen less than fluorine. Fluorine less than neon. Because neon is a fulfilled case. Eight electrons are stable. That is fulfilled case. Now, in second period, lithium less than beryllium. Beryllium greater than boron. Boron less than carbon. So these are the be careful cases. Here is the differentiation. Here also identifies, just this is identification necessary. So these are perfect ionization energy order. Generally decreases, but accurately like this. Okay, lithium less than beryllium greater than boron, less than carbon, carbon less than nitrogen, nitrogen greater than oxygen, oxygen less than fluorine, fluorine less than neon. Okay, it is, my dear boys, it is all about first ionization enthalpy setting. All these are first ionization enthalpies. Now I am going to explain second ionization enthalpies for the same element. Second means remove one electron. Remove electron. So now second electron affinities are it is 2s0. 2s0 means 1s2 is there. 1s2 is there. It is 2s1, remove an electron. After removing, there is the electron conversion. 2s2, 2p0. 2s2, 2p0. Now it is 2s2, 2p1. It is 2s2, 2p2. It is 2s2, 2p3. It is 2s2, 2p4. It is 2s2, 2p5. 2s2, 2p5. Okay, now only consider red electronic configurations, red electronic configurations. Okay, so see here, please neglect this. After removing one electron, these are the electronic configurations. Only consider this then. After removing one electron. Okay, now what is the stability order? Now, no electron is here, not considered. It is a helium configuration. Helium configuration is very, very stable. That is why it has high ionization enthalpy. High ionization enthalpy. Okay, therefore, now I am going to explain second ionization enthalpy. That is lithium greater than beryllium, any half field. When compared to half field, full field is more stable. Any so lithium greater than beryllium less than, once again it is a full field case. Any now it is a full field. Now beryllium less than boron, boron greater than, because carbon and full field case. Any boron greater than carbon, carbon less than nitrogen. So nitrogen is this one. So nitrogen less than oxygen, because oxygen is half filled. Oxygen is half filled, which is less than fluorine, which is less than neon. It is all about second ionization enthalpy. These are all second ionization enthalpy. Second ionization, that means if you want to find out third ionization energy, remove two electrons, identify that electronic configuration. Remove that electron. Yes, oxygen greater than fluorine. Sorry. Exactly correct. You correct. Oxygen greater than fluorine, because half field condition, full field, half field condition. Oxygen should be greater than fluorine. Okay, so these are the ionization energies, and some cases are these easy or difficult. Okay, now I am going to explain some problems based on this ionization energy. See here. So please be mind, IP value of any single electron species, IP value of any single electron species is calculated using the formula, that is IP is equal to 13.6 into Z square. It is the ionization energy calculating formula. So 13.6 into Z square, this formula is, I am going to derive in atomic structure topic. So up to now, please be mind, IP is equal to 13.6 into Z square. It is electron volt per atom are the units. Electron volt per atom is the unit. In electron volt per atom, IP is equal to 13.6 into Z square. Here, Z is the atomic number of elements. Atomic number of elements, my dear boys, it is only for single electron species. Single electron species. That means, for example, what is the ionization energy of lithium? Lithium, its atomic number is 3. That is 1s2, 2s1, and it contains 3 electrons. This is applicable, not applicable. This is not applicable. Now, Li plus means removal of this one. And it contains 2 electrons, not applicable. Now, Li plus 2 means one more electron is removed. And now, it contains 1 electron. And it is applicable. Okay, so applicable only for a single electron species. Next, He plus, is this applicable or not? He plus. For He plus, it is applicable. Yes, it is applicable. HG, 1s2 only. So plus means removal of one electron. It is 1s1, right? Single electron species, applicable. Li plus 3, applicable. So for any single electron species, ionization energy is calculated for using formula IP is equal to 13.6 into Z square electron volt per atom. Please be mind. Applicable only for a single electron system. Now calculations. Among lithium and Li plus, which one ionization energy is more? Li and Li plus, ionization energy is more for which one? Tell me. Li plus. Okay. Li plus and Li plus 2, which one has more? Li plus and Li plus 2, which one has more? S plus 2. Okay. Now see here. What is the IP value of? IP value of hydrogen in electron volt per atom. What is the IP value of hydrogen in electron volt per atom? Yes, 13.6. Because hydrogen, it contains only one electron. Applicable our formula. That is, IP is equal to 13.6 into Z square. For hydrogen, Z is equal to 1. Therefore, 13.6 electron volt per atom. It is 13.6 electron volt per atom. Simplest formula. Now, for Li plus 2, IP is equal to how much? For Li plus 2, IP is equal to how much? Li plus 2 is also a single electron system, already I explained to you. Now, IP is equal to 13.6 into, for lithium, hydrogen, helium, lithium, 3 and E. So, 3 square electron volt per atom. And so, 13.6 into 9. 13.6 into 9. That is how much? 122.4 electron volt per atom. So just multiply with that value. That's enough. 122.4 electron volt per atom. So this is the way to calculate ionization energy for a single electron system. For a single electron system. Next one. IP value of an element is 5 electron volt per atom. 5 electron volt per atom. Its value in kilojoule per mole is how much? Its value in kilojoule per mole is how much? First of all, you should know the conversion. 1 electron volt is equal to 96.5 kilojoule per mole. So please be mind, 1 electron volt is equal to 96.45 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so now it is, and once again, 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules. 1 electron volt is equal to 23.03 kilocalories. All these conversions you should remember. You should remember all these values. Now our topic is convert that value into kilos. Use this conversion. Okay, 482.25. So 1 electron volt is equal to 96.45. 5 electron volts is equal to how much? So multiply this one with 5. That is how much? 432.25 kilojoules per mole. So you should remember these values. 1 electron volt is equal to, you should remember it. Yes, I will send the notes. Please wait. I will send the notes, no doubt. So once again, one more problem. Very, very important model. Please be mind. Calculate the energy required to convert all the atoms of magnesium to magnesium ion. Present in present in 24 milligrams of magnesium vapor. Yes. First and second IP values of magnesium are 737.76 and 1450.73 kilojoule per mole respectively. So this is the value, any very, very important model. Calculate the total energy required to convert that 24 milligrams. So my dear boys, the values given to you are per mole. Per mole values. See here. There is magnesium vapor, nothing but gaseous state. This magnesium, after losing one electron, which is also in gaseous state, plus one, by the loss of one electron, that is ionization enthalpy, that is delta H of first ionization enthalpy is equal to delta H is nothing but enthalpy and ionization enthalpy. Delta H1, first ionization enthalpy is this much. So ionization enthalpy is always endothermic. Already I explained to you. So now this value is 736.76 kilojoule per, that is kilojoule per mole. Next, that magnesium Mg plus ion, which is also in gaseous state, converts into Mg plus 2 by the loss of one more electron. Here delta H2 is equal to, this is given to you, 1450.73 kilojoules per mole. Okay. Add these two equations. See here. Here, left side, Mg plus, right side, Mg plus, cancel each other. Now, Mg, which is in gaseous state, gives Mg plus 2 by the loss of 2 electrons. Electron plus electron, 2 electrons. There, delta H, add the delta H values also. 3, 6, 9, 7, 7, 14, 6, 6, 12, how much it is? 1450.73. Add these two values, 9, 14, 7, 8, 11, 2187. Am I correct? Yes. It is 2187.49 kilojoule per mole. That means for one mole magnesium conversion, this much energy is required. For one mole, that much energy is required. Now, see here, for Mg gas, one mole converts into Mg plus 2 gas ions. It is also one mole. The energy required for that one is energy required, that is delta E and delta H, and is 2187.73 energy required. So one mole means its atomic weight. Atomic weight means magnesium atomic weight 24 grams. Magnesium atomic weight 24 grams required 2187.73 kilojoules of energy. 24 grams. Here you want to calculate 24 milligrams. 24 into 10 power minus 3 grams and milligrams. 24 milligrams means 24 into 10 power minus 3 grams required how much energy? Okay, so now let it be X. Therefore, X is equal to 2187.73 into 24 into 10 power minus 3 by 24. Cancel any. Therefore, by 2.187 kilojoules of energy is required. 2.187 kilojoules of energy is required. So from this data, because your calculations for one mole, the values are all given to you one mole. So one mole value is this much. So 24 grams required this much value. 2.4, that is 0.024, that is milligrams required how much value. Okay, so this is very, very important. So, is this clear? Is this clear or not? Okay. So like this, number of problems I will send to you. Okay. So solve yourself. Solve yourself. Okay. Now, so some bits based on ionization energy. Some bits based on ionization energy. Which of the following represents IP? See here, option one. Metal gas gives M plus gas plus electron. Sorry, it is solid. Electron. Next, metal gas gives M plus plus electron. Next, metal gas gives M plus gas plus electron. metal gas gives m gas plus electron. Which one represents ionization energy? So no doubt, it is in gaseous state. This one also in gaseous state. That should be ionization energy. This is the correct one. Option. Next, which exhibits, which of the following has highest ionization energy or ionization potential? Na plus, next Al plus 3, next Mg plus 2, next F minus. Which one has greatest IP, highest IP among these four values? Let it be 1, 2, 3, 4. Tell me, which is the correct? Which one has highest ionization energy? So my dear boys, answer is 2 ending. 2 ending. So because it is negative ending, ionization energy negative. Negative means already accepted electron. Removal is easy ending. But here already 3 electrons are lost ending. More is the positive charge, more is the IP. More is the positive charge, more is the IP. So there is nuclear charge is more there. Answer is plus 3. Here, IP directly proportional to nuclear charge. That is the condition. Next. Which of the following electronic configuration exhibit highest IP2? Highest IP2. Option 1. 1s2, 2s2. Second one. 1s2, 2s1. Third one. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. Fourth one. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Second IP. Second IP. Which one has the greatest second IP? One. Second IP. Second IP means after removing one electron, identify. Third IP means after removing two electrons, identify. First IP means directly identify. Okay? Second IP means after removal of first one electron ending. So remove one electron. So this is 1. It is 0. It is 0. It is 5. Now identify. Now this is the correct one ending. Okay. So that is the highest second IP ending. Now the important application of this ionization energy is it is used to calculate group number of the element ending. Ionization energy is useful for application. See here. Ionization energy. Very, very important and interesting one. See here. Ionization energy is very useful. Ionization energy is very useful to identify. To identify. First one, valence electrons, that is the number of electrons present in outermost orbitand. Number of electrons present in the outermost, that should be calculated. Next, second one. It is used to calculate, predict oxidation states of elements. If you know the next, their valence electrons is equal to group number and that is, if you know the valence electrons, you should identify the group number. Once group number, you should identify that oxidation state, you should identify it. Once oxidation state is there, so used. This oxidation state is used to write the formula. Is used to write the formula. So, see how. See here. Let us take one example. That is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. What is nothing more? It is boron. Its atomic number 5. This is the electronic configuration. This is inner orbit. This is outer orbit. 2, 2. It is the last orbit in n side. It is n minus 1 side. Okay. See here. 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. It is inner orbit. It is outermost orbit. Electrons present in the outermost orbit are very easy to remove than that of inner orbit. So removal of these three electrons easier than 1s2 electrons. So electrons present in 1s orbit. Removal of these three electrons is easier than, but that means when compared to these two electrons, removing these three are easy. But anyway, no doubt this is easy, this is something more, this is something more. So now total how many ionization enthalpies are available? 5 ionization enthalpies are available, and because 5 electrons are there, 5 ionization enthalpies. So now I am going to write 5 ionization enthalpies here. First ionization enthalpy, that is 130 kilojoule per mole. Second ionization enthalpy, 250 kilojoule per mole. Kilojoule per mole. Third ionization enthalpy, 570 kilojoule per mole. So fourth ionization enthalpy, 1200 kilojoule per mole. Fifth ionization enthalpy, 1400 kilojoule per mole. These are the different ionization enthalpy values for this statement. See here, find out the difference. See here, 130, 250, almost nearer, just 100, 120 is different. 250, 270 any. So nearly 250 or 260 difference any. So next, 500 to 1200, nearly a large difference is there. Large difference is. So that means identify between which values the largest difference is you should observe. The largest difference of energy values is between this one and this one. That means up to these valence electrons, remaining electrons are core electrons. Remaining electrons are core electrons. That means three values are there, means three electrons in the valency shell. Number of electrons in the valency shell is equal to valency. Valency is equal to 3. So number of electrons in the valency shell 3 means that is third A group element. That is third A group element. Therefore, number of valency electrons. So third A group element means it has +3 oxidation state or +1 oxidation state are possible. +3 oxidation state or +1. That is the prediction. It's just a prediction. Three electrons are there. So if this one electron or these three electrons may be involved in the oxidation state, that means +1 or +3 are possible. That means there is a sudden large jump between, there is a large jump between the values identified. Where that large jump is identified. So cut that one before the remaining values are all. Up to that, the values are valency, remaining are core electrons. So now I'm going to explain one more. See here. Here an element A, I don't know its ionization enthalpy values are given as 70 kilojoule per mole, 110 kilojoule per mole, 300 kilojoule per mole, 500 kilojoule per mole, 1800 kilojoule per mole, 2100 kilojoule per mole, etc. Now, valence electrons is equal to how much? group number is equal to how much? Oxidation states is equal to what are what? So sudden jump in the ionization energy values. 70, 110, 300, 500, a little difference between them and it. But 518, that is the large jump. And so these are the valency electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, valency electrons is equal to 4. Valency electrons be a 4 means, so that is 4th A and 4th A and that is 14th group and. Valence electrons is equal to 4 means 4th A or 14th group element. So 14th group element has plus 2 or plus 4 are the common oxygen states. And plus 2 or plus 4. So it's oxide. Oxide means, so that element with oxygen formula. Oxygen has always minus 2 and possible oxides. It may be plus 2 or it may be plus 4 and. Therefore, by using this, AO is the possible oxide or AO2 is the possible oxide. AO or AO2. Or write it, sulfate. Sulfate formula. Sulfate means A plus 2 or A plus 4 are possible. So, sulfate means SO4 minus 2, SO4 minus 2. Therefore, the formula is ASO4 or ASO4 twice are the product compounds. So like this, right? It's a chloride. That means A plus 2 or A plus 4 are possible. Chloride means Cl minus N. Therefore, ACl2 or ACl4 are the possible cases. ACl2.